We're exploring the 21 myths of relaxation. At number 6, stress causes you to take many sick days off from work. True or false, Cecil?
Well, this is a very interesting question, a concern. And it's interesting because it caused me to create a product for this. I actually created a product for this because I met a lawyer many years ago and he says to me, Cecil, one of my problems is when I finish work, when I'm supposed to finish work, I take my work home. He says, when I go home, I can't spend time with my wife and children because I take work home. I don't know how to stop it. And so that's what triggered me, like, oh, this is a problem. So what happens is, if you are constantly taking work home, so you have a 9-to-5 job, let's assume you have a 9-to-5 job,
yeah,
which you get paid for,
mm-hmm,
and then you go home to an unpaid job, which is, you know, whatever you do at home when you get home. But what happened, there's no separation of work and home. So you say you start to work at 7 and you finish at 3 or whatever. So you have this long day where there's no pause. You haven't even breathed for the whole day because you've gone from one job to the other job, but there's no separation. Consequently, you will be all stressed out. I met a lady once who says she would be all stressed out and she would have this migraine headache and it started on Monday. And she would, on Friday then, she was looking forward to Friday because she had the weekend off. So on the weekend then, she would rest. And the whole weekend she would rest. Monday, she comes back home, not relaxed, but she goes through the whole cycle. So I met her and I'm saying, excuse me, what are you talking about? She says, well, Cecil, I have this migraine on Monday, and I know on Friday I'm going to go and relax, and that's going to be the end of that. And I'm saying, you're crazy. I said, well, take the CD, listen to it. Just listen to the evening part of it. So I saw her in the next week, and she says, Cecil, next day, no problem. I said, what do you mean, no problem? No migraine. I said, what do you mean? She says, well, I didn't realize that I was waiting till Friday to deal with the problem. That's the time for only time I took a break. In 5 days, she took a break on Friday. Mm-hmm. And I said, no. You need to take a break every evening. So what happened is she then took the break every evening. Now, this is an example where she took a migraine off. But you know, in a situation where a lot of people take off from work for a whole bunch of other reasons. And this is just an example of what caused them to be off from work, because they can't handle the stresses, and the stresses just become so profound, the next thing they go to the doctor, and the doctor has to give them some form of medication in order to help them cope. So that's the whole issue. The other issue we have is that we're not focused. What do you focus on? Most people don't even know what they want. That's a whole other story. But in the context of going to work, most people don't know what they want at work. Most people are in jobs they don't even like. They're just doing the jobs in order to make some money. So, and they can't even say, well, I don't like this job, let me look for something else. That don't seem to be an option. So if you're in a job where you don't like, it means that you're going to be off sick because something ain't right and you're not happy, and consequences, you're going to be off from work. And I don't really have the numbers in front of me, but there's some numbers that say how many people have been off work and how much it costs the employer when people are off work, and the work's still got to be done.
Yeah.
There's a big expense to the employer for people who are off from work. And it's a very simple issue. They get, you know, the employees are taught how to stay focused, how to deal with the stresses of life, how to separate the work from home, then the issue would be resolved quite easily. And the employer would have not only employees at work, but you would have people who are now productive. Even if you're an entrepreneurial person, the same thing happens to you. I mean, you would know because you're working for yourself, so you're not going to notice it, but it will affect you in the context that you're now behind the eight ball and things that need to be done. And the issue is that we don't know how to separate work from home. And when you learn how to do that, that's why I created a product called Staying Connected, so people can solve that problem.
Mm-hmm. Almost worse for entrepreneurs at home, especially because you're always working. You always have the work right there in front of you.
Yes, and they don't know how to stop and take a break, and unfortunately it affects the whole health issues, because it's like, what do they do? And if they're working long hours, they don't notice it. I mean, other people are telling me I'm working long hours, but they're saying, well, I'm an entrepreneur, I got to do it. But in reality, you do not need to work those long hours. If you are focused in the morning, focused on what you want to do, and you can separate your work from home, then you'll find that you have a lot more time to have fun and to enjoy life and to have a better health, have better health and enjoy yourself and your family or whatever you choose to do.
Great. There you go. The 21 myths of relaxation at number 6. Stress causes you to take many sick days off from work. Thanks, Cecil.
You're welcome, Wayne.
If you enjoyed this video, then you will also enjoy 6 ways to be rich lifestyle.